join the webinar shortly.
Just kindly allow me to share.
Please.
Just a small sharing that Dr. Elal Manjunatha is, I think participants are able to read this. Any participant may confirm that they are able to see this.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It's visible, sir.
Our esteemed speaker or source person of the day, Dr. Elal Manjunatha, is BE, MBA, PGD, FMA, PhD, and postgraduate with postgraduate program in concrete technology from UK. He is zonal head and associate vice president JSW Cement, and he is chairman of Indian Concrete Institute Bangalore Center. He got his BE from reputed UVC Bangalore University, MBA in 99, again from very reputed institute, and so on. So I welcome Dr. Manjunatha sir in today's session, and with this brief profile, I request him. I have been hearing him in so many webinars organized by so many bodies of the country. So we are very fortunate to have him this morning, despite his hectic schedule ahead. So I am very grateful and request him to take over today's session, sir.
Thank you, sir. It's a great honor for me that such a big university has invited me for the presentation today. My presentation is visible now?
Yes, sir. It is visible, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, recording started, right? Okay,
yes, yeah. Sir. Yes, sir. With your permission, sir.
Yeah. Okay. The slides are moving?
Yes, yes, sir. Slides are moving, sir.
Okay, okay. Thank you. Thank you. Dear friends, respected faculty from Kota Rajasthan University, I wish to come and make a physical presentation once with the invitation of Dr. Praveen Kumar. Since because of the pandemic, we are not able to come, and I am doing an online webinar session. My dear students and faculty members and other participants from the industry. Today, I'm going to talk about steel industry byproducts for sustainable constructions. So we know construction has been there. The moment the man stopped living in the caves, he wanted to have a house of his own. Then he started constructing thatched roofs and huts. Then he started doing mud buildings. Then later on, he started moving to shelters. So construction industry evolved. So the first people were the Romans who invented concrete. Concreta, it comes from Latin world, and they started making concrete using volcanic ash. Then they started making concrete using animal blood as an admixture. They started using straw, horse hair for reinforcement. The best examples are the Roman Colosseum and other buildings. Aqueducts which have been built in Rome, still even after 2500 years, they are there as a testimony. They are monumental buildings. So as such, the concrete industry started progressing very fast after the invention of cement. 1824, Joseph Aspidin, a bricklayer in a village called Portland in England, he invented the cement. The first concrete was made in 1828. Okay. So since then, the journey of concrete started in a small scale. They were making in the small kilns. Then a rotary kiln was invented somewhere between 1850 to 1860. In that range, the innovations in the rotary kiln happened, and mass invention of cement happened. Mass production of cement started doing all over the world. and the industry has grown. Today, close to 4.2 billion tons of cement is being produced all over the world. In China, number one, they produce about 1,800 to 2,000 million tons per year. India is second. The capacity is 550 million tons, and we are producing close to about 400 million tons. Second largest country in the world to consume cement. But I cannot say consume cement, produce cement. Per capita consumption is still very low, and we may be about 150 to 160 kg per capita. And going forward, it will be about 200 plus. So as we continuously consume natural resources to make cement, to make aggregates, to produce concrete, because close to 13 to 14 billion cubic meter of concrete is being made globally. Okay, that is the numbers. So with that, there's a continuous innovation happening how to use the industry byproducts. We all know fly ash is the one product which was coming from thermal power plants by burning coal to generate steam. And also now currently it's under decline because of the conversion to conventional energies, from conversion to sustainable energies. We are now moving towards wind energy, solar energy, hydroelectric energy, and photovoltaic cells, and we are planning to store energy in the batteries and all. So nuclear energy. So the dependency on the coal is coming down, and the production of energy through coal is coming down. So we are going to have a lesser availability of fly ash, diminishing. Similar way, the steel industry is booming. Currently, the installed capacity is 130 million tons in India. So it's going to be 300 million by 2030. So each ton of steel production generates about 300 kgs of slag. So how the slag is manufactured, I'm going to talk about all that. So this is a byproduct of steel industry. So using this slag, there are varieties of slag: blast furnace slag, EAF slag, electric arc furnace slag, steel slag. So there are 4 to 5 varieties of slags are available. How we can convert into useful products, especially when you make these products. So the main two biggest industries are agriculture and construction. Agriculture as such, the slags were being utilized as a fertilizers by conversion, and we have abundant availability of fertilizers available in the country. The next mode of usage was the construction of roads and buildings. Okay, construction industry. So how to develop these byproducts, convert them to useful products, and how they have been helping to reduce the carbon footprint, sustainability. This is what I'm going to talk about today. So coming to my company where I work, JSW, one of the largest industrial house in India, about $14 billion turnover. And we are the largest steel company in India in terms of in the private sector, and also one of the largest in Asia. Close to about 20 million tons capacity is there, going to be about 60 million tons capacity. So that is the way forward for JSW Steel. And we continue to make steel and produce slag. Apart from steel, we have energy. We produce both conventional energy and also non-conventional energy from renewable sources, energy from wind, energy from hydroelectric sectors, and cement. We entered into cement in 2009 to convert our slag into cement products. The journey has been phenomenal, and we are a growth, one of the fastest growing cement company in India. Close to about 14 million, and varieties of GGBS we are producing. And also, we have our own ports and jetties. The JSW infrastructure takes care of handling cargoes, seaports and all. And very recently, we launched JSW Paints, both decorative and industrial paints we are making. And in this segment also, we are making eco-friendly paints. And you can get 14,000 colors without paying extra money. Different varieties of colors can be made. That's what we are making. So a contribution to the success of Indian story is phenomenal. Not only in the manufacturing sector we are there, we are into sports. Delhi Capitals, we are the co-owners. Then Rajasthan, I mean, like, we have this Haryana Steelers, Kabaddi team, and Bangalore Football Club, and also Inspire Institute of Sports is one institute we have started in association with various industrial bodies to train the Olympic athletes. So in that way, JSW is contributing a big way in sports sector. Apart from that, as a part of social responsibility, education is one field we are helping lakhs of people nearby our plants to have the proper education, food and nutrition programs. So this is what part of the JSW journey. We are mainly present in the southern, western and eastern India. Very soon we are launching a factory in Rajasthan, Kota. I mean, Kota is the capital. Rajasthan, we have bought some limestone because Rajasthan is rich in limestones. Maybe a year or so, we may start a cement plant in Rajasthan also. Okay. That's the journey of JSW, this thing. Various products we have. We have JSW PSC cement, which is eco-friendly cement, one of the greenest cement in the country. Then we have blended composite cement, JSW Comsem, which is available in southern India. It's a blend of fly ash and slag together. And Concrete HD is one more grade of slag cement, which is gives similar strength like OPC cement. In spite of using slag, we can give strength parameters equivalent to OPC cement. Because everybody is using OPC cement in many parts of the country, especially south, they use OPC cement. So just to bring about sustainability in the construction, we have launched these products. GGBS is one product we are manufacturing to supply to RMC industry and project segments, where they have their own batching plants and captive plants, where they blend the GGBS along with the OPC cement to make various grades of concretes. Okay. Then slag sand, okay. We know the scarcity of sand is there everywhere in every part of the country because of the banning of the sand, dredging of the sand from river basins from various governments, but it's not an environmental friendly activity. So in order to cater to that segment, we have launched slag sand, and which is gaining popularity in southern parts of India and western parts of India, and close to about 1 to 1.5 lakh tons of sand we are selling every month. This is a product which we recently launched. Friends, this is our capacity. This was as on about 1 year back. 12.5 million ton capacity was there, and we have added further addition, and now we are close to 14 million tons. By 2020, it will be about 20 million, 2020 to 2023, it will be about 22 million tons. So coming to the main topic of the today presentation, challenges, the challenges the world is facing, phenomenal. Okay, by 2050, we're talking about 9.8 billion population living on the planet. Currently, it's about 7 billion population. Okay, so in that, 80% of the world population is moving towards urban environment, cities. Because of the better medical facilities, better health facilities, job opportunities, people are moving towards city. The migration of people is phenomenal in India compared to any other parts of the world. Because take Europe or America, they are completely urbanized. But the maximum movement of the urban the rural population move towards city will happen in India and China. Because these two countries are having the highest population. Okay, so we continuously create more and more concrete jungles. So when we create concrete jungles, what is going to happen? The passage of water will increase because we are concretizing the urban environment. Okay, more and more agricultural lands are getting converted to layouts, apartments, IT parks, industrial parks. Because of that, what will happen? That the water percolation, when it dries, doesn't happen at all. It starts flowing on the roads and buildings, and you are going to have urban floods. With that, we are going to have completely the cities getting flooded during the heavy rainfall. So more concrete jungle leads to urban heat island effect because of the free flow of air doesn't happen when the buildings are available, buildings are there. Then powerful typhoons are coming in the ocean. We are seeing many typhoons and hurricanes and cyclones affecting the coastal environment. Being Rajasthani, you may not be experiencing this kind of weather, because in coastal we are having this kind of a thing, because India is having more than 6,700 kilometers of coastline. The impact of this and social and environmental conditions, global warming. Okay, these are the things which are going to happen. So you can look at the picture, this 91% of the world population are exposed to the air pollution and the concentration of carbon dioxide. This is the World Health Organization estimate. So you see, most part of India, especially in, you can see North India, Africa, Sahara deserts, and other parts of the Asian continent, these areas are having more pollutions. So continuous emission of the carbon dioxide lead to greenhouse gas effects, and with that we are going to have urban heat effect. The city is getting more and more warmer. This is the environment we are getting. Okay. So coming to the industrial sector, steel and cement, they contribute close to 7% by steel and 5% by cement. About 12% of carbon dioxide emissions happens because of these two activities. 60% is by thermal activity. It's coming down, shrinking. I got one more slide. This thing graph I would like to show. Now, globally, the cement and the steel contribute maximum carbon dioxide emissions. Okay. So construction will not stop, as we all know. It's a continuous activity. We continue to build high-rise buildings. We take cities like Bangalore, Hyderabad, Mumbai, Delhi. They are continuously building high-rise because the constraint on land availability is increasing. As we continuously move towards urban transport, metros, we need to continuously build tall structures surrounding this central business district where the metro lines are going because of the government allowing higher FAR ratio. So continuously we're developing cities, tall buildings are coming, and with that, like construction activity will continuously keep on increasing. Okay, so look at this building. These buildings, the Roman Colosseum, was built 2000 years ago, and still it is a testimony. The building is standing, and they did not use at that time cement concrete. It was only a lime concrete. So sustainability, how to bring sustainability in construction? The bottom line is we should have a sustainable construction continuously happening, should be viable, environmentally viable, the equitable, bearable, and should give both environmental impact, economic benefit, social impact. Okay, this is what we are looking from sustainability index point of view. Sustainability is nothing but reducing the carbon dioxide emissions using local materials and bringing global technologies. So ultimately, we are aiming at lower energy consumption, lower carbon dioxide emissions from the construction activity, and giving a prolonged life to the buildings, increasing life cycle cost, reducing the life cycle cost and increasing durability of the building. So a green building is one building which helps in reducing the carbon footprint, increased productivity, improved health, and occupation of the building. It helps people to live a peaceful life. So coming to the sustainability in concrete, dear friends, in concrete I'm going to have many ingredients. We have got cement, we have got aggregates, we have got fine aggregates, then we use water. In Rajasthan, maybe availability of water scarce commodity. Okay, how to conserve water while doing concrete is very important because we need water for making concrete as well as for curing concrete. So improved durability of the structures. The structures what we build, like we were talking about Roman Colosseum, it is there for more than 2000 years. So when we build structures, it's not for ourselves, it's for our generation, next generations. Okay, maybe if the land value goes up, people may try to put a higher building, higher buildings and all, because of the land value going up. So otherwise, people who build their own houses, it's for the lifetime, for the children lifetime, that's what they're building. So sustainability in concrete making comes in various ways. Cement, okay. How we can bring sustainability in cement? Cement, as I've already told you, liberates about 1 ton of cement, liberates about 800 kgs of carbon dioxide, that is OPC cement. So you can bring about sustainability in cement by using supplemented cementitious material like fly ash and slag, GGBS. Okay, that is one thing we can do. Aggregates also, we can use recycled aggregates from the demolition of the old buildings. That's one aspect. Second is that we can make slag aggregates. We can make copper slag aggregates. We can make fly ash based aggregates and all. So using these materials, the replacement up to 25 to 50% or 100% based on the concrete grade. For lean concrete, we can go up to 100%. So we can replace the virgin material using this construction demolition waste and also the slag industry byproducts. So fine aggregates, replacement for sand. We've got many available byproducts. M sand is available. Then we have slag sand available, copper slag sand available. So any industries which are developed, emitting byproducts, releasing byproducts that can be usefully converted into fine aggregates. Then water. So reduce the water demand using various techniques, using water reducing admixtures, using curing compounds. You can reduce the demand for water. So Rajasthan, as a state like Rajasthan, where it's a part of our place is desert and all, water availability is a big challenge. So we need to adopt technology like using PC based admixtures, which will reduce the water demand by almost 30%. Okay. Then improve durability. With all that, whether my durability of the concrete is getting affected or not, it's a challenge. I'm telling you, friends, using all these replacements, the durability aspect is not going to be affected at all. You're going to get more and more durable buildings only. That is what I'm going to advocate you in the next slides of my presentations. So finally, we are looking at doubling the concrete strength, or strength-controlled members. That's what we are looking at. So some necessary points for achieving durability performance. So we are looking at improving the performance of the concrete by making the particle packing effect very with the concrete. And also keeping the water cement ratio as low as possible. That's what we are looking at actually. Should use good quality fine aggregates like slag and fly ash. So gone are the days of excessive use of OPC and water. We have to reduce the usage of OPC, pure OPC cement and water. However, curing is very important in the concrete making. One second. It was a small thing. Okay. However, curing is very important in concrete making. So, dear friends, the new generation green materials, which are eco-friendly, looking at the point of mineral admixtures, chemical admixtures, alternative to river sand, and alternative to coarse aggregates. So, these are various types of alternative materials available in the construction field now. It has been developed with scientific research and this can be adopted and also being adopted everywhere, each and every part of the world, not only in India. People are moving towards sustainable construction. They're moving towards net zero building. That means that the entire building life cycle, they don't emit any carbon dioxide. Okay. So that's the way we are looking at to develop sustainable solutions for construction. And coming to the one product which always comes on your mind is the sand. So everywhere you can get a high quality cement because it's being manufactured by reputed companies, corporates and all. So you don't have any problem in cement. When it comes to sand, you have a problem because sand is traded by locally. Local agents will give sand. We don't know what is mixing, how from where is bringing and all. So the quality of sand is always an issue when by selecting sand. And nowadays the river sand has been completely banned. Okay. Because if you are using sand from the river basin, there's an issue. The flow of water in the river is getting down every day. And we have a problem in terms of the groundwater sinking day by day because of the continuous dredging of the sand from the river basin. Okay. So considering that all over the country and the river sand has been completely banned, So we know that there's an UN report on sand mining. They're talking about close to 59 billion tons of sand is mined globally for the construction activity. Okay, so this is a huge number, looking at the material demand. So we need to use alternative materials to bring down the dependency on the natural materials, because natural materials are not going to be available continuously. So this is one river basin. You can see it's kilometers together in China, because a continuous dredging of the river basin for sand make the river completely barren. There's no water flowing in this river at all. So our in India also considering the ecological imbalance, and people stopped the dredging of the river sand. Some parts it's available whenever there's excess sand available, because of the you need to continuously maintain the depth of the river, otherwise the water will start flooding everywhere. So to keep that this thing, they allow a certain portion of the river to be dredged and mined for sand. So this Rally for River by Sadhguru Jaggi Vasudev, he started Kaveri, to say the Kaveri, all along the Kaveri basin, they wanted to plant about 1 kilometer trees, so that the flow of water in the Kaveri basin, which was earlier perennial river, which is now not flowing every month, every season. So they wanted to improve the flow in the river basin. That's what they are planning now. Earlier, like we demolished the river basin by continuously dredging the river sand. So if I give you a sand which is equivalent to river sand, okay, from a byproduct, will you not accept it, which is similar like river sand in terms of property, in fact better than river sand in terms of purity of the sand? If I give you one kind of sand, you will definitely accept. So in that direction, JSW has done a lot of innovation and research work to reduce the dependency of sand on the river basins. Okay, so when we look at the river sand, we have a scarcity and environmental issues and legal issues are there. So to replace all that, so we have developed technologies called alternative aggregates. Okay, the government of Karnataka also come out with a circular that the manufactured sand can be used. So this manufactured sand comes from various sources, from breaking the mountains. Okay, even breaking the mountains for sand, it's not an eco-friendly activity. For aggregates, you are breaking the mountains by using crushers and all. But if you start doing for sand also, it's not going to be very environmental friendly. So considering that, even Karnataka government, they started importing sand from Malaysia. They were trying to sell in bags. That also did not materialize. So then JSW came into picture to manufacture sand from the steel slag. Okay, these are the various manufacturing process we have. So for M sand, the advantages are many. Okay, it's a ecologically benefiting product. Okay, it's eco-friendly because it avoids the dredging of the rivers. And looking at the advantages, greater durability, performance enhancement is there. You are going to get higher strength in the concrete and also greater workability compared to the river sand. These are the advantages of M sand. So this is one of its kind in the country. JSW has installed a sand manufacturing factory at our Bellari Toranagallu. This is sand being manufactured using our slag, which is a byproduct of steel industry. So we know, I would like to talk about more on slag. A lot of research work has happened in many universities, many colleges on slag sand, and they have come out with excellent results. So what is slag? Slag is a byproduct of steel industry. It's a non-metallic product. It's a product of silicates and aluminum silicates of lime, which we use for making steel. It's a byproduct. So I would like to give about how it is being manufactured through a pictorial presentations. This is the pictorial presentation. This is the iron making, where we have a blast furnace, where we are going to add iron ore, then we are going to add fluxes and coking coal. These three ingredients along with the iron ore gets into the blast furnace. Here we are going to heat it up to 1500 to 1600 degrees centigrade. When we heat the this raw meal into 1600 degree centigrade, you are going to get iron, molten iron, that will be taken to steel production. Then about 30% for every ton of the flux we had, we get about 250 to 300 kgs of slag, which is the byproduct. So this byproduct is taken out and quenched using chilling water into granules. So this is a highly mineral rich product, which can be utilized to making various products. So in steel making also we generate the slag. As I told you, in iron making we generate 350 kgs per ton. In steel making we generate about 200 kgs per ton. So this is what we get in the steel making. It's quite substantial quantity considering the steel production in India about 130 million tons. So slag dumping happening. So this was the earlier method. People used to dump slag and all. They were not bothered. But in countries like Europe, Germany and other European countries, they started using slag long ago, more than 100 years ago, converting into useful products. So this is like just like a mountain of slag. But it is being now consumed completely into valuable products. So how we convert into useful product? When the slag comes on the, this we have got a separate setup. Through that it flows, okay, we will put water jets and a blowing box. So with that, it gets converted to small granules. So with that, granulated, become granulated blast furnace slag, used for fine aggregates. So when we do the air cooling, we don't do this methodology from the steel making. We get air-cooled LD slag, which is a little bit darker in nature. We make coarse aggregates from this. So, as I told you, and these products are very eco-friendly products, which satisfy the requirement of your aggregates, and it can be utilized at each and every application. Roads, construction, concrete making, house building, everything we can make using. So, looking at the specifications, I have given a small gist of specifications here. River sand is there, and also GBFS, the original material. So it was not meeting the exact requirement in our specific gravity and density, because river sand density was 1400 1700 degrees kg per meter cube, and this slag was giving 1000 to 1100 kg per meter cube density. Specific gravity was also less, and water absorption was a bit more compared to the river sand. So what we have done, to remove the oversized particles, bulk density, specific gravity, we used a manufacturing process, as I told you, first of its kind in the country, and converted the granulated blast furnace slag into processed granulated blast furnace slag, which meets the requirement of our IS standard as well as the specifications of river sand. So the processed one is having the particle shape completely improved, no sharp edges. The processed granulated blast furnace slag was similar like a river sand. The granulated blast furnace slag, the stage getting converted into finished product. The processed one having round shape, the particles, and also uniform particle size it's having. And looking at the gradation curve, the processed slag, what we call manufactured sand, meets the requirement of gradation, zone 2 specifications as per our river sand. So you can see a changed product. The density is already improved to 1500 kg per meter cube, come from the GBS, which was earlier raw material. And even the specific gravity also 2.65, and meeting as per the river sand specifications. Water absorption less than 3%. So by changing the product by process industry technology, using global technologies and also manufacturing process, we can modify the product to meet the river sand specifications. You can also look at the advantages. In case of the slag sand, we don't have the marine products, about 2 to 4%, the river sand which is having. Because river sand is a natural sand which flows through hundreds of kilometers before we take it as a river sand. So we get oversized particles, clay and silt. So it's a mixture of everything. We need to really sieve the sand to get the good quality reverse side for plastering or concrete applications. In case of slag sand, it's a ready-made product from a manufacturing process. So this is the advantage of slag sand. So even though this product was being dumped earlier, now it is being used as a useful product for construction applications. You can see the comparison between slag sand and river sand, having the similar shape, particle size, and this is the microscopic picture. And we have modified the particle size, which is similar like river sand. And also, through various research work, we have found that even though code is now giving about 50% replacement for plain concrete, 25% replacement of structural RCC, we can use 100%. We have done various study, and we are now requesting the Bureau of Indian Standard to allow us to go with 100% replacement. That may happen very soon. So, see, to accept any products, my dear friends and students, you need to analyze various properties, chemical tests and physical tests, physical properties. We need to conduct and ascertain the properties as per the IS 383 specifications. So, we have done all the tests at various reputed laboratories like Indian Institute of Science, NCCBM, and various laboratories in India, Bureau Veritas. So, we can see even though we replace 100% sand, these are the example, natural river sand, this is the strength, 7-day, 28-day strength, 100%, this is the strength, 100% processed sand, this one, 50% processed slag sand, 50% natural sand. So, we have found there is no drop in the compressive strength, rather than it's an improvement in the compressive strength when we use the slag sand. We have done also a flowability test, durability parameters, acid test, acid medium, alkali silica reactions, everything we have done the testing as per the requirement. This is the manufacturing process. People who are there in southern India, all the colleges, they keep visiting this plant just to see how the manufacturing. Since you are very far away in Rajasthan, I can only show you the photograph. If you wish to come and see the plant, you can make it also. There's no problem. The permission will be given to see the plant. Using the slag sand, we manufactured many products and many applications are there. We can use it for airport, highways, plastering application, building. And the government of Karnataka, PWD, has approved usage of steel industry byproducts in the their specifications. Pollution Control Board also has given the clearance. This should be used. These are the various testimonies we have. Slag is the best alternative to river sand. Expert opinion also is there in various leading magazines. So there's a comparison. Many articles have come in leading newspapers, how it is eco-friendly, how it is helping. So these are the various applications, my dear students and friends. And like we have done, because we have got almost 10 square kilometer campus near Bellary, that's Vijayanagar. We have our housing colonies, factories. It's a big setup, like Jamshedpur. It's much bigger than Jamshedpur. It's an industrial town. So for all the building construction, we have used this product for plastering, pavement quality concrete, buildings. You can see the structures, even heavy duty floorings also we have done with these products. JSW steel mills, because we are putting this all the steel coils on the flooring. And also we have working with all the nearby areas, the village roads, then Bangalore, we are using this Ozone Urbana road works. And government projects, Nirmiti Kendra projects, they have started recommending and using the slag sand. Then Karnataka Power Corporation Limited. So many projects they are continuously using the road construction. Karnataka Rural Infrastructure Limited, there also. So it's approved by all the parties. So it's a completely slag road being built by Gaman India. And the recent change in the IS 383 specifications. Earlier, they were mentioning it's a natural source. The aggregates, the finer cores should come from natural source, because at that time, 1970, abundantly the natural materials were available. But nowadays, the code got a revision in 2015. they have mentioned that manufactured aggregates can be used. So in the code also, the usage of aggregates from the artificial sources like byproducts is approved now, there is no problem at all. This is the growth of dispatches year on year. The demand for the slag sand is improving. So coming to the next stage of the product, the slag can get converted into GGBS, ultra fine slag and cement. Okay, so we take that blast furnace slag and take it to cement mill. Using a vertical shaft mill, we ground it to fine powder. So this become part of a cementitious material. It's called GGBS, very eco-friendly product, and close to 3 million tons per year is being consumed in South and Western India. So, dear friends, you can ask me, sir, okay, this product is very good, I know. Can I use it in the concrete applications anywhere? You can use, because IS 456, table number 5, clearly mentions the usage of fly ash or ground granulated blast furnace slag in the concrete making in various percentages based on the exposure conditions, mild, moderate, severe, very severe, extreme conditions. We can use this product on various grades of concrete. We have done M100 grade concrete also using GGBS. The mineralogy of the slag, I want to share. There's an IS code, IS 12089. They say the manufacturer of slag should have these following properties. Okay, the glass content is one which they talk about, 85%. What we are manufacturing, JSW, is between 90% to 95%, which is almost similar like a slag from Japan. Japan are the people who are expert in making a good quality steel. There they take out the slag, they consume 100% of slag in all the concrete productions. Whatever they make slag in the steel mills, one of the biggest country in the world, it manufactures steel, Japan. So they consume 100% slag, which is being produced from the steel mills. And also, similar way, IS 456, 2000, considering the durability parameters, when the sulfides and chlorides are there, exposure conditions, table 4. So they clearly mention the usage of slag cement for the when both we have chlorides and sulfates in the concrete. So coming to the percentages usage, based on the applications, we can use this slag in the concrete making, starting from you have a ground structures. Early strength is required, can go to 25% to 35%. When we have underground structures, 35% to 50%. So when you have mass concreting applications, about 50% to 65%, especially raft foundation, 1 meter above raft foundations. Generally, they will go with high percentage of slag to reduce the temperature. Differential temperature between the top surface and the middle of the concrete should not be more than 20 degrees centigrade. So many raft foundations, they are, you have to control the temperature during the initial stage. They are going with replacement of OPC cement with slag. And there are concrete structures which are built in the marine environment, sewage treatment plants, where 70% is a must, because these structures come across sulfate attack, chloride attack, acid attack, alkali silica reactions. So the concrete has to be very strong. If you make with pure OPC cement, 100% the concrete will deteriorate within 5 to 10 years. So to have a structure more than 100 years, you need to go with an higher replacement of slag. These are the various benefits of using the slag. You get a lesser cracking in the initial stage. Workability is very good. Then improved concrete properties, both in the initial stage and the final stage. Improved resistance to acid, chloride, sulfate attack, fire. Even the fire resistance also is improved using the GGBS. So final benefit, increased durability, reduced life cycle cost. That is the advantage. Improved ultimate and flexural strength, maximum reduction in heat of hydration, high impermeability, resistance to chemical attacks. These are the main four benefits of using slag in the construction and concrete. This is one important equation you should all remember. Morning before coming, I was explaining to my daughter, who's taking she's a civil engineering eighth semester student, and she was giving a presentation on slag today to their college. And she was asking me this equation. I was explaining to her, when we had OPC cement with water, we are going to have a reaction called exothermic reaction, where we get calcium silicate hydrate gel. It's the DNA of the concrete. Okay, then we get calcium hydroxide. This is about 50 to 65%, or 25% calcium hydroxide, which is weak component. I can say it's a cancer in the cancer cell in the body. So this, if it is there in the body, it start leaching out. You can see white patches coming out after 3-4 days of concrete making. This is called calcium hydroxide. So this is detrimental. Generally, the sulfates and chlorates and carbonation happens because of this product. Water penetration will happen. So this product, once again, reacts with GGBS, if you add slag or GGBS, and develops into additional calcium silicate hydrate gel through secondary reactions. So this will attack this calcium hydroxide and convert it to calcium silicate hydrate gel. This is the pictorial presentation. This is the presentation, the line diagram. You can see additional calcium silicate hydrate gels being formed because of the hydration process. This is the line diagram. I've already explained to you. It's a beautiful product. It may not be available in Rajasthan currently now, but if you want, you can get material. We can give you for research work and all. So you have to pay the freight for that. So you can do a lot of research work and all. Very soon, you also may start getting the slag if the more steel plants come in that area also. This I've already explained to you, the improved performance. And many case studies, I don't want to spend much time. Already it's 10 o'clock. So it's a testimony of the usage of the product in various projects. Tricon RMC, Shobha Indraprastha project, Bangalore Metro Corporation, Pune Metro Corporation, Mumbai Metro Corporation, Chennai Metro Corporation. Many government departments are using these products. This is the various case studies. I don't want to spend much time on this. Let me go through quickly. There's an improvement in the strength compared to the fly ash mixes. Use slag in the concrete. It's one of such product where they used slag, the fair finished concrete. I mean, like they've not done any plasting here. They have done a finishing coat. This was a Maiwan formwork technology. One of the biggest mall in India, which is got opened recently, Shobha Mall, Globus Mall. With concrete, the strength parameters. So you can see M25 grade concrete, which used 170 kg OPC, 170 kg GGBS, has developed almost 56 MPa strength. This is the record I have taken from their laboratory, because we had kept the cubes for 56 days, 90 days, 180 days. And because you may not believe me, because generally we type numbers and all, because this is the record I have taken from their laboratory. So so that you understand that data is authentic. This is Bangalore Metro. In all the stages of Bangalore Metro, they have adopted for various grades of concrete. This is the trials our team did along with the Bangalore Metro team, because earlier they were not ready to accept these products. Everybody is having their own doubts when any new product comes and done. So we worked with everybody, did the trials, mixed designs, and then it was successful. And now each and every package they start, they come first, what is your GGBS rate? We want to include in our specifications, they want to use, like that they are telling. And also in the various labs, we have done the strength parameters, M25, M30. You can clearly see the growth of strength, the PSC cement. PSC cement strength much higher than the OPC cement. This is RMC industry in India. Continuously it's growing. Way back in 1990, it started. 1992, the first RMC plant was started in Pune. So growth has been phenomenal because of the huge demand for concrete happening in the project cycle. So the first phase of development was only in 78 cities. I feel now each and every city is having now RMC plants. Maybe more than 200 cities and towns in India are having more than 6,000 plants. This is the growth. I was part of the RMC India, and I traveled across India to establish RMC plants. You can see the growth of RMC industry growing. So in the RMC industry, it was definitely demand for the this cementitious material is increasing. So globally, GGBS is getting accepted everywhere because of its technological benefit. So you can see the product getting used in many other applications like concrete blocks, AC sheet manufacturing, chemical admixtures, and also we are exporting to many countries. And we can make special concretes using this slag industry byproducts, pervious concretes, tamped concrete, self-compacting concrete, then white topping, fiber-reinforced concrete, high early strength concrete, using advanced modification in the admixtures, coastal environment, high durable concrete, colored concrete. It's very good for colored concrete because the GGBS is white in nature, so it requires the demand for pigment. With a lesser pigment concentration, we can make a colored concrete using this. Maintaining and repairing potholes, making high early strength concrete, we can do the repair mortars, using repair mortars. So many governments have approved this product, Karnataka PWD, Tamil Nadu PWD, IRC, for the PQC, IRC 15-2017, they have approved for PQC, CPWD. These are all central government establishments, they have approved. Then defense establishments, they have approved. Chennai Metro Corporation, many national highways. This is a list of the customers whom we have. Mainly L&T, India, BL Kashyap, Purvankara. These are the HCC. If you look at Afghans, they may be present in Rajasthan also. HED cementation. Many RMC plants, national players are using this product. So I want to conclude my presentation using the steel industry byproducts. It may be sand, maybe GGBS or DSC cement or composite cement. It's a very eco-friendly activity and it's very good. It's a green products that are certified by IGBC. So I would like to conclude, my dear students and my dear friends, that start adopting these alternative materials and technologies, and you can do research work. The product is not available. You just you can be in touch with me. I'll try to get you the product, and you may have to spend some money for transportation, and we have got people who can send you to your place also if you require, okay, with the flight charges and all. You can do research work on GGBS and slag sand and start using these products for better performance, better durability. At the end of the day, we are saving our planet because, you know, as I've already told you in the beginning of my presentation, that the carbon dioxide emissions are mainly being contributed by steel and cement industry. We continuously going to use steel and cement together for our construction, that we don't have any replacement for these two products. So as we continuously increase the usage of this product, our responsibility being civil engineers in the field of construction is to reduce the carbon footprint and achieve sustainability, durability. Can be done both in terms of economics benefit. You can use this product, GGBS and slag sand, for your construction. These products are a Green 4 certified product. All the products are certified. So with that, I would like to conclude my presentation. I thank Dr. Praveen Kumar and Agarwal sir for providing this opportunity. Probably, if time permit, I would like to visit Rajasthan Kota to deliver a physical presentation to all the students. Thank you, sir. Over to you.
Thank you. And we are overwhelmed with your presentation and explanation in a concise way. Participants can unmute themselves and ask any query or questions directly. Participants, please ask any question. Sir, most of them are from South India.
Oh, okay.
Basically, from 21 states, they are here. From Tamil.
Oh, very nice. Very nice to hear 21 states. It's a national integration then.
Yes, sir. Yes. From Tamil Nadu, around 40. Telangana, Kerala, Andhra.
They're all my friends. They know me through Indian Concrete Institute. Very nice.
Yes, sir. So nice, sir. So, any questions from your participants? Any our participants? If no queries,
myself.
yes. Yes, one participant was asking.
Sir, myself, Sasi Kumar from Tamil Nadu.
Yeah, Hishi Kumar. Yes, sir.
Sir, what about the cement production for the special concretes? What are the types of cements available in your organization for the special making special concrete? Like
So
AIOC cement.
we have OPC cement which you can blend at the site in RMC plants with using GGBS. Then we have slag cement. Concrete HD is one slag cement which in a lesser percentage of slag. It performs similar like OPC cement. It's a durable cement, eco-friendly cement. Then we have PSC cement that is with a higher percentage of slag for the durable structures like marine structures. And directly for builders, and they can make use of this product. Then we have composite cement. Composite cement is a blended cement where we use slag and fly ash together to make the blended cement. And slag sand is available. And recently, we have launched admixtures also, chemical admixtures, that ready plaster we have launched, waterproofing products we have launched, floor hardening compounds we have launched. All these products are sustainable in the sense we use industry byproducts. Along with cementitious material to make these products.
Yes, really. When compared to other organizations, JSW have an variety of cements available in the market when compared to
Yeah,
other
yeah.
organizations.
That's
Which
very
one?
true. Starting from OPC, we have variety. That is the innovations we are continuously doing as a company to deliver sustainable product to the consumers. That is our this thing. Or him.
Yes, sir. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Somebody has asked, what about nanomaterials, sir? The nanomaterials are like nano silica, ultrafine fly ash, ultrafine GGBS. These are all nanomaterials. Their particle size is about 10,000 meter square per kg. Very fine materials. They are used for high grades of concrete, reactive powder concrete, high early strength concrete. Okay. So these are changing the trend, nanomaterials and all. Maybe very soon we may get concrete, self-curing concrete using nanotechnology. Okay. And we can eliminate the water. Currently, we are reduced up to 0.24 water cement ratio. Okay. Further, we can bring down because nanomaterials are material which gives high improved workability. So, a lot of innovation is happening in terms of nanomaterials, also usage of nanomaterials in the concrete industry. We are having concrete grade up to M700, the reactive powder concrete, bendable concrete, lateral concrete. These are the types of concrete we are developed already. It is there. Then blast resistance concrete. So many types of concretes are available.
One participant is asking, is nanomaterial available in your company? Sir, we are not getting your voice.
Market you have to find out and start using. Yeah.
I think you are answered. What type of admixtures can be
So any other
used?
questions are there, I'm ready to answer.
Yes, sir. In chat box, there are some questions. May kindly refer if anything.
What kind of admixture can be used? We use GGBS because of fixed setting. So nowadays, these PC-based admixtures are available. They are very good admixtures. GGBS, you don't require fixed setting admixtures. If you are doing precast, like you want about 18 MPa, 20 MPa strength, then at that time you can use about 30% GGBS. But Fosroc has developed new admixtures where you can use up to 70% GGBS even for precast segments because of the advantage, the kind of finish you get, phenomenal. Okay, so admixtures are available, BASF, Fosroc, Asian Paints, many companies have started admixtures manufacturing. There are PC based admixture, low range, high range, mid PC, all these things are available that can be utilized for concrete making.
One participant has written to me that, of course, very useful and informative presentation. He has done study on foundry sand.
Okay.
And he requests you to give him some idea how to take that concept to common public or stakeholders.
Yeah, correct. Yeah, foundry sands are sand which are rich in silica. So these sands after certain usage are being thrown actually. You can contact me and definitely useful products can be made. So I don't know what kind of quantities available and what kind of quality is there. We can check and ascertain these products and all. That can be utilized either by blending with natural sand or this thing. See, now because like now the blending technology is very famous. We can blend, use any product. We have got composite cement, we have got slag cement, we have PPC. So, and aggregates also now we are blending natural aggregates with artificial aggregates. So it's a, now concrete has become a mixture of admixtures. Okay. So we can use those products. There's no problem. And you have to publish some certain papers and that I can also help them. Then make it, give presentations to people nearby where the foundry slag sand is available. And we can definitely make use of that product in the constructive way.
Another query, he is asking that the participant that have you tried in developing Ferroc, a carbon negative material? Ferroc, have you tried in developing Ferroc?
No. See, like we are trying to reduce the carbon footprint in our all products by using alternative materials like slag or fly ash and all. So we are not developing any carbon neutral product. Most of the research work is happening in Europe regarding carbon neutral economy. By 2050, they want to become completely carbon neutral. In cement manufacturing also, they want to make net zero emitting RMC, cement plants. So all this, they are developing, they are working very closely because now they have reached a stage that they can implement all those things. In India, we are continuously growing. Demand for construction is continuously happening. And we are adopting quickly, there's no doubt. And we are not as a matured economy like other countries, like developed countries.
With this, I think most of the queries have been replied. As other, all the queries till now have been replied. If there are no further queries, may I propose the closure of the session? Further queries, if any, may be mailed to Dr. Manjunatha, sir. I will share his mail ID in the common WhatsApp group with the participants, if allowed.
Sure, sir. You can add me my name also. I will interact. I mean, like, we keep doing many programs through Indian Concrete Institute, and I'll share the sessions network also. You can add me in the WhatsApp group. There's no problem. I can answer all the questions.
So nice of you, sir. So with this, I express again my gratitude to the esteemed speaker of the today morning, Dr. Manjunatha, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you. And for sparing time. And definitely, we will be in touch and we will work. We will like to be to work together in research work at our.
Sure, any research help required from my side, I'm ready to help the university. You can like call me and now we don't have to physically come. We can interact through Zoom or web meeting and I'll be able to chair the session for R&D people. No problem.
So nice of you. And few participants are requesting to share your PPT or PDF if possible. You may send.
I will share it to you, sir. I will send it to you. You can share it to everybody. There's no problem.
So nice of you. Thank you.
I request this video presentation of mine to send it to me.
Okay, sir. Definitely, sir. Definitely.
I am uploading this to my YouTube channel so that it's available to millions of people.
Yes, sir. I will upload on YouTube and share with URL to you and recording also again separately to you, sir.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you.